Hi guys, welcome to Good Dog Grooming. My name's Colleen. Today I am going to demonstrate how I like to trim most dogs' tails. Now this works especially well with doodles, which is what Augie is, but it applies to many, many breeds and many, many tails. So far all I've done on Augie is a number 7 shave down. This is just a rough and dirty garage room, so nothing too fancy here. And I have not touched his head yet, so I brushed his tail out. The way I like to start is to take whatever length I did on the body and run it down the top of the tail. Not all the way down, but basically blend it down. So let's do that first. I did a number 7 on his body, so let me go ahead and do that on the top of his tail. Make sure the tail is all the way brushed out. Now I'm continuing. And floating off the top of that tail. All right?
Great.
So here I'm totally against the body. And up to about here I start floating so that it blends. And I go a little to the right and a little to the left also. Okay, so I'm happy with the top of that. Now, if you have a dog with that tight curly hair and a lot of it's going off to the sides, you can narrow that in as well, because I like to do blending from short to long, and it doesn't just suddenly happen. I like it to gradually happen. And so if you've got that fur that sticks out, well then brush it purposely out like that and then blend it a little bit. So I'm gonna exaggerate what I did on the top and do it also a little bit on the side here. Float off. All right. So, I'm shaping his tail the way I want. That's step one, is to do that top and maybe the sides, okay? I'm gonna trim his booty just a little bit better. Good boy. Okay, so now I'm ready for my step two. I blended off the top of this tail here. Now I like to brush everything down, as downward as I can get it. Every tail is different. Some tails cooperate more with this downward brush because they're so curly, they just want to stick up, and that's fine. So no matter what type of fur you're working with, just kind of roughly part it down the middle and brush it down, down, down. And you can gently hold the tail to do this, okay? Because we are going to scissor from the booty and make your poop shoot. I like to do a pretty extreme angle right there. All right, so I've got it. Down, down, down. And I'm gonna make the poop shoot. Say, and I usually do this, starting close to the butthole and working my way down as best I can. Don't be afraid to brush again and do it again. Straight line, maybe a slight curve, and you kind of have to, since it is three-dimensional, you kind of have to do it from that side and from that side. Does that make sense? So you're making a line, but you also have to turn your scissors this way and do that side, and you have to turn your scissors that way and do that side. Okay. Stay. Okay. I'm pretty happy with that. Now I'm gonna recomb it, but it's the same process, straight down like that. I'm gonna come from the other way and just shake my flag. Come here. Now, how much you cut off here is up to you. And it depends too on how long you've trimmed the body. If he had a very fluffy haircut, I would leave more on. But to create a little bit more balance, I'm gonna take a fair amount of length off. Let me do this step. And all I'm gonna do is make sure you know where the tip of the tail is. And I'm gonna start maybe a couple inches past that. The tip of the tail is right in between my fingertips. So I'm gonna start here, and I'm just gonna do a nice shape, sort of an upside down rainbow right here. I'm gonna get my scissors, there we go. All right, I'm just gonna go right in there and knock this right off, right down the middle. follow the curve of his tail. Okay, and now I need to do that a little to the left and a little to the right. Now, the last step is to sort of rebrush and get whatever you missed. And if you want to be real kind of fancy, you can even take your chunkers at the end and smooth out any imperfections that you see. But for the most part, that's it. That's how I do a doodle tail and many other tails. And if you see any stragglers up here, you can even scissor those off a bit. And when you're taking your scissors and doing this, just make sure you're aware of how close the tip of your scissors are to the dog's butt.
All right, so that was Augie's tail. Please bear in mind, I have not touched his head yet. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Thanks so much for watching. Bye, guys. Good boy.